Hey there, friends. Welcome to The In-Between and our series on Heroes of Faith.
In this series, we're going through the Bible, looking at people who lived lives of great faith in God. There are some wonderful examples for us in the pages of Scripture.
For sure. And hopefully by looking at their lives, we can learn how to put our faith and trust in God the way that they did.
Jeff, are we going back to the Hall of Heroes today?
Of course. It's where all the great exhibits are. Guys, The In-Between has an interactive Bible museum with an entire hall dedicated to the heroes of the faith from the Bible.
It is so cool, but I don't remember how we got there in the first place.
Well, remember, it's that handshake you did.
Oh, yeah, okay. Wow, man, that is so cool. So now that we're here, should we go inside the museum?
For sure, let's go, come on.
Whoa, I don't remember that exhibit from last time.
Yeah, I think it's new. I think it's a revolving set of exhibits.
Okay.
They're always changing, yeah. Huh, oh, let's keep going.
Oh gosh, there's that Hero sandwich place again. Oh, do we dare trying to go there again?
I don't know, it was a little bit weird.
I know, it was
Maybe we
weird.
Give it a shot? I don't know. Let's think about it. Wait, here, we are at the Hall of Heroes.
Oh, right, yes.
Okay, Claire. Do you remember what faith means?
Well, faith is having complete confidence or trust in something or someone. The Bible defines it as having confidence in what we hope for and assurance of what we do not see. That's from Hebrews 11:1.
Yeah, having faith is simply believing that God is who he says he is and that he's able to do what he says he will do in his word.
When we have confidence in God, it enables us to live lives of faith.
Last time we learned about Abel. Let's keep going to this next exhibit. It's probably a story that many of you are familiar with. Can you guess who it's about?
Yes, it's the story of Noah. I bet a lot of you already know the story of Noah. In fact, it's hard to just say Noah and not say Noah and the Ark.
That's right. You can read all about Noah and the Ark in Genesis chapters 6-9. During Noah's time, the world was filled with wickedness, so much that God was deeply grieved by it. He saw the attitudes and hearts of mankind and that they were all wicked all the time.
All the time?
All the time.
Yikes. Well, fortunately, Noah found favor in the eyes of the Lord. He was a righteous man, a good and honest man who was faithful to God.
Now, God told Noah to build a big boat, an ark, and to put two of every kind of animal and bird and insect inside of it.
God then brought a flood. It rained for 150 days, and then the waters subsided for another 150 days, and then the earth dried out for 70 more days. Noah and his family and all the animals were in that boat for like 370 days. That's almost a year, or I guess a little over a year.
Yeah. That was impressive. That was an incredibly brief overview, Claire.
Yeah, we told that overview in like 5 sentences.
Quickest I've ever told that story. Wow.
I'm hoping our viewers are familiar enough with the general story so that we can spend some time talking about Noah and his faith.
Yeah, so Noah is commended as being someone who showed great faith. In the book of Hebrews in the New Testament, it says in chapter 11, verse 7, "By faith, Noah, when warned about things not yet seen, in holy fear, built an ark to save his family."
Imagine you're Noah. Everything around you is bad news. The earth is filled with evil. And then God tells you to build an ark because he is going to destroy all life on earth. I have several follow-up questions.
What do you mean?
Well, first, what? Next, when? Where? How? Does Noah even know how to build an ark?
Okay, well, those are good questions. Well, God gives him very specific instructions on how to build the boat. The measurements, what materials to use, all of it.
Okay, so let's just go through the account and list the ways that Noah showed faith and believed God. Number one, Noah doesn't ask like a million follow-up questions like I wanted to ask, right? He believes that God is going to bring the flood. So he gets to the business of building the ark.
Yeah, that's right, Claire. Here's an important part too. Noah doesn't live by the ocean.
Nope.
He lives in the desert, completely landlocked. What do you think his neighbors thought of him building a giant boat in the middle of the desert?
Yeah. What did they think? Guys, the ark was big. It was 450 feet long, 75 feet wide and 45 feet tall. And here Noah is just working away on it. He was probably ridiculed and made fun of by the people around him. And we already learned that they were evil, so I don't guess they were friendly about his building project.
Yeah, you're right. But Noah believed God, so he kept right on working until it was finished. And building the ark took a long time. When he'd finished, it was time to bring the animals and supplies and get everyone inside.
There is another part where Noah showed great faith in something he couldn't understand. How in the world was Noah going to get two of every kind of animal into that boat? I can't even get my own cat into a cat carrier to go to the vet.
That's fair, right? Noah believed God, though. He trusted that if the God of the universe had asked him to get two of every kind of animal in the world into that boat, then he would enable Noah to do it.
And that's exactly what happened. Genesis 7:5 says, "And Noah did all that the Lord commanded him." Noah did all that the Lord commanded him. That's how he showed faith, through his obedience to God. Do you know what, guys? We can show faith that way too.
That's right. We can do what the Lord commands by reading his word. God speaks to us through the Bible. We learn what it means to be obedient to Jesus by reading and applying what we learn in the Bible, God's true word to us.
Now, even though this story of Noah happened a long time ago, let's see how we can show faith like he did in today's world.
That was a great example of how we can show our faith in God by not following the people around us into sin.
Yes, Leah refused to gossip about her friend Madison and stood up for what was right. Guys, it can be really hard to behave differently in the world around us, but as followers of Christ, that's what we are told to do.
Now the challenge for you today, go out and be a hero of faith in your community.
Exactly. Now Jeff, I am hungry. What do you say we go back to Heroes Heroes and give them another chance?
Really? Are you sure about that?
I don't know. Maybe those kids' parents are back in the kitchen this time.
Let's see what the special of the day is, okay?
Okay, let's go.
All right.
Well, here we are again.
Wow.
I'm guessing they have, that must have been a fluke. There's no way that those
It wasn't
kids...
really the real special.
Yeah,
it could be a different special. They might have just mixed up the days and the food order.
I'm looking for a menu.
Supply chain issues,
options,
maybe. I don't know.
But the only thing I can click on is the special.
Okay. Well, maybe they revamped it. Maybe they got some feedback. I'm sure they got some feedback, some honest feedback.
Clearly.
Yesterday.
I spit mine out. Let's try it.
Welcome to Heroes Heroes. Today's special consists of...
I feel welcomed.
Ham and cheese.
Oh, a loaf? A ham and cheese loaf? No.
What? No, you shouldn't do that.
Black licorice.
What?
Oh, okay,
what?
It's the black...
Rainbow licorice.
Oh my gosh, all the licorice flavors?
Do one, why not
pudding.
What?
Stop it. Pudding.
That's a side. Okay.
Oh, celery
sticks. Let's
see
how our expert chefs made today's sandwich.
Okay, we got expert chefs. We got expert chefs this time. Oh, they're back! Oh, please don't do that, child.
What is she doing? No. No,
please.
No.
Call her mother. Call her father. Call the parent. No, don't. Okay. Don't you do it.
Oh. It's like sweet mayonnaise. Wait,
there's
a parent
there. There's a responsible
adult
there. Somebody.
Help them.
What did it? Oh, is that
No, why
celery?
Is she? No, she wants them to
I
make
don't
it like
understand.
That.
They seem so confident, and that's what frightens me.
Yeah, he looks really
pleased. And the black licorice, classic choice.
Look at this. Nicobis? That's what he called the licorice.
Should we be doing this? We asked can we, but we didn't ask should we. And I think this is like,
is the spoon part of the meal?
This is where it fell apart in Jurassic Park, and we shouldn't be doing this. The children
I'd like to see that little girl try a wasabi pea.
They're sure not going to do anything else to it, are they?
Sweet child,
please.
So the full bowl of celery.
Use your finger, young man, sir.
Oh, that's better. Okay, look, he's problem solving. No. There, you got one slice.
But he's making another
problem.
Sir. Oh my. Okay. But that's all of it right there on it. I appreciate the gesture, but that's not gonna help me very much.
I don't want to eat that, Jeff. Show me
another
special.
I feel like we should call
special.
Some kind of authority.
A sandwich.
Okay.
For the kids.
There's pudding on the licorice. Okay.
I hope you like our sandwich. No.
So bad.
Oh my gosh. No.
Okay.
I don't like the ham. I don't like the ham! Okay!
I couldn't do it.
Pudding and licorice and ham?
I couldn't do it.
Oh, you still have sandwich in your beard.
Oh, no.
No.
Oh, it won't go away.
Okay, Jeff's gonna get cleaned up, and we hope to see you guys next time.
Hey, friends, we hope you enjoyed this episode.
Wait. You should do the funny accent.
Okay, let's go.
Okay.
Just start over?
Yeah. Make sure to like.
Subscribe.
Now we're Australian. And also ring the bell so that you never miss
another episode.